Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And as I was preparing for the homily last night, I was thinking about the devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. I was very fortunate that I grew up in a house which was very devotional, and we went to Mass every Sunday. We also prayed the rosary when we were little kids, and my parents could actually get us to do so. But one of the devotions, I'm looking back over the years, is I remember when we would go down the stairs, there was probably a 2 foot by 3 foot picture of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And you would see in all the glitter around the robe, etc. But you saw the Sacred Heart of Jesus there. So every time you come down the stairs, first thing in the morning, you saw the Sacred Heart of Jesus. I always thought that was kind of beautiful. And then inside the kitchen, on one of the walls, was another piece, not a smaller one, of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. But underneath it was an enrollment. We were enrolled, the family itself was enrolled in the Sacred Heart of Jesus. I think how beautiful and how fortunate and blessed that I was, and many of us are, to have grown up in households who are much like that, who have that great devotion to the Blessed Heart of Jesus. Today's second reading has a very beautiful verse inside there. It's very simple for us all to understand. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. That Sacred Heart of Jesus was a great image that I would always look to when I was going off to parochial school. And it always reminded me of the heart of Jesus and how much Jesus loves us. In our age today, we're very fortunate to have a Pope who calls out and encourages us to make this a church for the poor, for the marginalized, for those who are disenfranchised. When I hear God is love, I see that taken to action, when we actually really go off there and we try to take the message of the gospel to those who are much in need. Many of you folks already do that in prayer. And a lot of us do that inside the street corners when we help those who are in need. We help in various other ways. But we want to remember, we want to have as much of the Lord Jesus in our heart as we possibly can. Because the more of his love we have in our heart, the more good deeds we have. And I'm always remembered, we always remember, we can't bring any of the monetary or the physical things with us to heaven, but every good deed, every act of love we do in the name of the Sacred Heart of Jesus is something that we will have for our eternity in heaven. So take some time to reflect and just try to think about how is it that you really do live in the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Really quickly, I know when it comes to those who are in recovery, one of the exercises they have is somebody who gets into recovery, for example, alcohol, is they make them sit down and write a list and try to figure out how much money they've spent on alcohol over their lifetime. And when they look at it, it's staggering and it changes them. And it really helps in their sobriety. I wonder if we would take that time to sit down and try to compose a list of as many good deeds we've done over the years. Because that will give us a good sense as to where we stand today in our relationship with the Lord Jesus. And where truly our heart mirrors the Sacred Heart of Jesus.